In other online training videos, we have learned about our dimension tools and defaults. In this video, we'll take a look at dimensioning kitchen and bath wall elevations. First, I'll open this elevation view that I have created in this kitchen by selecting the elevation camera icon and then clicking on the Open View tool in the Edit toolbar here at the bottom. Or you can double-click on the camera to open the view. There are two ways to dimension in an elevation view: manual dimensions and automatic dimensions. Manual dimensions are created the same way you create them in the floor plan view. You can find the dimension tools under the CAD drop-down menu, under Dimensions. Here you can see all of the manual dimension tools. I typically use three of these in my elevation views: the manual dimension tool, the end-to-end dimension tool, and the point-to-point dimension tool. The manual dimension tool is used the same way you would use it in the floor plan view. You can also find the dimension tool parent tool here in your toolbar for quick access. Just click on the parent tool, then on the first tool in the child toolbar here on the left side of your screen. This is the manual dimension tool. Then click and drag a line across the object or objects that you want to dimension. Once you have created a dimension line, just like in floor plan view, it can be edited. You can move the line using the Move Edit handle. You can remove extension lines by clicking on the dimension line to get the diamond-shaped edit handle at the end of the extension lines. Then click on the one that you want to remove and drag it away from the object it's attached to. You can add extension lines by using the floating diamond edit handle that will always show up next to the Move edit handle. Click and drag this diamond to another object that you want your dimension to locate. You can also easily add centerline indicators on your dimension extensions. Just click on the extension line that you would like to call out as a centerline. Then here in the Edit toolbar at the bottom, click on the Mark as Center Line button. If you want to remove it, click here again, where the button has changed to the Remove Centerline Mark tool. The look and behavior of dimension lines will follow the active dimension defaults. If I go up here to the Default Settings tool, the little white wrench, and then down to Dimensions and to Dimensions below that, you will see all of the saved dimension defaults. Here at the bottom, you can see which of these is the active dimension default. But you can change it here by clicking this drop-down and selecting the saved dimension set you prefer. If I select one and click on Edit, you can find all of the settings that determine how your dimensions will behave and what they will look like, including the dimension line setup, the number format, the objects that will be located and where they are located, how the extension lines behave, and what layer the dimensions will be placed on, the style of the arrow, and the textile to be used. If I want a dimension line from the wall to the center line of the refrigerator, I could use the manual dimension tool, but notice that it will locate all of the objects between those two spots. So instead, I will use my end-to-end dimension tool. This will locate the first object, create an extension line to it, and then snap to the next, creating another extension line, until I move further. Then it will find the next object and remove the extension from the first object. As I continue, it will create one dimension relative only to the initial object located. It will find the top of the center of the refrigerator when I release the left pick button on my mouse. It will create a dimension line from one end to the other without locating all of the objects in between. If you have difficulty with the dimension line locating the object you want to dimension, you can use the point-to-point dimension tool. This tool will create its own dimension points if it cannot locate an object. Once you have drawn a dimension line and the dimension points, you can move the point and change the dimension. You can also use the dimension to move the point to a precise position by selecting the point marker and then click on the dimension number to open the editor. Now you can type in the precise number that you want. So if I want a dimension line that goes from the floor to the bottom of the vent, notice that it will not locate the bottom of the vent. So I will use the point-to-point dimension tool, which will place a dimension point. Then I will select the point, click on the number, and open the editor to type in the dimension that I need. You also have the option to use automatic dimensions. If we go here to the Automatic Dimensions tool, parent tool, you will find the Auto Elevation Dimensions tool. The look and behavior of these dimensions will follow the Auto Elevation tool defaults. You will find these again if we go to the Default Settings parent tool and then double-click on Auto Elevation Dimensions. The defaults found here will control some of the characteristics of the dimensions that generate. The dimensions position in the elevation view, top, bottom, left, and right, and the objects to be located by the extension lines. The layer that the dimension lines will be placed on are also controlled by the Auto Elevation Dimension defaults. All of the defaults not controlled here will be determined by the active dimension defaults that we discussed earlier, including the format, the extension settings, arrow style, and text style. Again, once you have created an automatic dimensions, you can edit them by moving the dimension lines and adding or removing extension lines. You can also make changes to each dimension line by selecting it and then clicking on the Open Object tool to open the Dimension Specification dialog. Here you can change the overall dimension defaults that it is following, or customize individual characteristics, like the format, extensions, layer, and arrow. If you have changed the Auto Elevation Dimension defaults after generating dimensions, you can update them easily by clicking again on the Auto Elevation Dimension tool. However, once you've customized an individual dimension line, remember that it will no longer update automatically when you click on the Auto Elevation Dimension tool, as the others do. An easy way to delete the dimensions all at once is to use the Active Tool Selection mode. Click on the Dimension Tool Parent tool. That will activate the Manual Dimension tool. Then hold down your Shift key and draw a selection box around everything. And because the dimension tool is active, it will only select the dimensions. Then click on the Delete button in the Edit toolbar at the bottom of your screen. This will not work by clicking on the Auto Elevation Dimension tool. That will simply regenerate the Auto Elevation dimensions. The other automatic dimension tool available for dimensioning wall elevations is the NKBA Auto Elevation Dimension tool. This tool has its own default settings for position, CAD object's location, and layer. To generate dimensions that follow the NKBA drawing standards, make sure to set the active dimension defaults to the NKBA dimension defaults. Like the Auto Elevation Dimension tools, the look and behavior of the dimensions generated will follow a combination of defaults, the current active dimension defaults, and the defaults for the NKBA Auto Elevation Dimension tool. In elevation views, you can use manual dimension tools and automatic dimension tools. The dimension line's appearance and behavior will be determined by the settings that you choose in each tool's defaults.